In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
Good morning.
Good morning, Father.
Today we celebrate God's love and mercy and forgiveness for all of us as we bow in silence and contemplate our sins. We were sent to heal the contrite. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Plead for us at the right hand of the Father.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who called the bishop, Saint Irenaeus, to confirm true doctrine and the peace of the Church, grant we pray through his intercession that being renewed in faith and charity, we may always be intent on fostering unity and concord. Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns through the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Genesis. Abraham and the men who had visited him by the labyrinth of Mamre set out from there and looked down towards Sodom. Abraham was walking with them to see them on their way. The Lord reflected, "Shall I hide from Abraham what I am about to do? Now that he is to become a great and populous nation, and all the nations of the earth are to find blessing in him. Indeed, I have singled him out, that he may direct his children and his household after him, to keep the way of the Lord by doing what is right and just, so that the Lord may carry into effect for Abraham the promise he made about him." Then the Lord said, "The outcry against Sodom and Gomorrah is so great, and their sin is so great, that I must go down and see whether or not their actions fully correspond to the cry against them that comes to me. I need to find out." While the two men walked on farther towards Sodom, the Lord remained standing before Abraham. Then Abraham drew nearer to him and said, "Will you sweep away the innocent with the guilty? Suppose there were 50 innocent people in the city, would you wipe out the place rather than spare it for the sake of the 50 innocent people within it? Far be it from you to do such a thing, to make the innocent die with the guilty, so that the innocent and the guilty would be treated alike. Should not the judge of all the world act with justice?" The Lord replied, "If I find 50 innocent people in the city of Sodom, I will spare the whole place for their sake." Abraham spoke up again, "See how I am promising to speak to my Lord, though I am but dust and ashes. What if there are 5 less than 50 innocent people? Will you destroy the whole city because of those 5? He answered, "I will not destroy it if I find 45 there." But Abraham persisted, saying, "What if only 40 are found there?" He replied, "I will forbear doing it for the sake of the 40. Then Abraham said, Let not, my Lord, grow impatient when it go on. What if only 30 are found there? He replied, I will forbear doing it if I can find but 30 there. Still, Abraham went on. Since I have thus dared to speak to my Lord, what if there are no more than 20? He answered, I will not destroy it for the sake of the 20. But he still persisted. Let not my Lord grow angry if I speak up this last time. What if there are at least 10 there? He replied, for the sake of those 10, I will not destroy it. The Lord departed as soon as he had finished speaking with Abraham, and Abraham returned home. The word of the Lord.
Praise be to God.
The Lord is kind and merciful.
The Lord is kind and merciful.
Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all my beings, bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits.
The Lord is kind and merciful.
He pardons all your iniquities. He heals all your ills. He redeems your life from destruction. He crowns you with kindness and compassion.
The Lord is kind and merciful.
Merciful and gracious is the Lord, slow to anger and abounding in kindness. He will not always chide, nor does he keep his wrath forever.
The Lord is kind and merciful.
Not according to our sins does he deal with us, nor does he requite us according to our crimes. For as the heavens are high above the earth, so surpassing is his kindness toward those who fear him.
Emboldened, about 40. God says, well, and he gets
Responsorial Psalm said that the Lord is kind and merciful. So God looks at Sodom and Gomorrah and says, okay, we've had a negotiator for you. Now, I don't know if God looked at the world today, what would he say? There's innocent people that seek John Dean. We're not going to do anything to the world because of those wonderful people that seek John Dean. I don't know, we need to pray for our world, right? That's the goal. Celebrating the love and mercy of God, we pray for our church's leaders and all God's people. We pray to the Lord.
Lord,
pray for peace and harmony among peoples and nations. We pray to the Lord.
Lord,
pray for those who are sick in hospitals, doctors, and care workers. We pray to the Lord.
Lord,
we celebrate your love and kindness today. Help us to be your faithful servants, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, Almighty Father.
In the house of sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the glory of the church.
In sacrifice, we offer you joy on this heavenly birthday of St. Irenaeus. Bring your glory, O Lord, and instill in us love of the truth, so that we keep the church faithful and inviolate. Unity secure through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
He is right and just.
Truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, O Holy Father, almighty and eternal God. For the blood of your blessed martyr, St. Irenaeus, poured out by Christ to glorify your name, shows forth your marvelous works, for which now in our redemption. To your power, and on the feeble bestow strength to bear you witness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And so with the powers of heaven we worship you constantly on earth, before your majesty without end, we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
So that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. given up for you. So the way we so presented, he took the chalice, once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins, and this in memory of me." Our mystery of faith.
Thank you.
These sacred mysteries, we pray, O Lord, given us your compassion and increase of that faith, which brought glory to Bishop St. Irenaeus as he maintained it even until death. In the same faith, bring us who truly follow our justification in your sight. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
God bless us, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace and glorify the Lord for your love.
Thanks be to God.